Hey, what's up? What's going on? Welcome, my peace, my peoples. Let's talk about Escape, still kicking at season one, episode two. So we start off finding out that there was another member of Escape that actually get to make the billboard, and her name is Tan, and she actually meets up with Candy at the OLG restaurant. Candy doing double promotion on that restaurant. You go, Candy. And actually, you know, Tan was a member of the group, but since they really wanted this manager, and this manager did not care for Tan, so he made them choose between Tan or him, and they chose him. And Candy felt like they should have had her back more. They should have supported her. They should have stand tall, but they didn't. And so, you know, Candy's talking about, you know, Tan, I can't meet up with you to do these things, to go on vacation with you, because I'm doing all these new engagements with the group and all this other stuff. It's just busy and there's so many things lined up. And so Tan goes, so why? And Candy goes, you know why? Because of the money. And so Tan goes, some things never change. And she goes, Tan, you know, since you know the girls, you know, because, you know, Tan knows them for years, and she's Candy's best friend, and they've been friends for since they was 14. And actually, you know, Tan says that, so Candy tells Tan that, you know, these girls, they went behind her back and put her name on a trademark and started a business in her name, and they didn't even tell her about it. So how do you feel about that, Tan? Because you're a businesswoman. And Tan says, some shit never change. Things don't never change. Sometimes when people are all about the money, all about what they want, you know, they don't really care about you. They'll lie to you. They act like they're your friend, and they really care about you, really want to rock with you, but really, in actuality, they just want to use you, laugh in your face, and steal your money behind your back. So that's how Tan feels about, you know, Tamika and, you know, Tasha. I was like, oh shit. And so, you know, and then we get to Tasha. You know, Tasha talks about, you know, Rocky managing them, and she managed, you know, he managed the Escape group for their second album, and their third album. He managed Escape. And so, and he was like, you know, she was like, he did us a favor. He was a good manager and all this other stuff. And Candy was like, no, he was a terrible manager. He didn't really know what he was doing, because it was his first time ever managing a group. And you can tell by how things just went down, he didn't know what he was really doing, because he didn't have any experience. So he would step in. And also Candy was like, Tasha, you know, when he became like the manager, she got really crazy with it. Like, she didn't want to share the same dressing room as the other ladies, and she didn't want to pray with the girls anymore. And it's just like she left all of them alone while she was doing her own thing, and she just left them three by themselves until it was time to perform or whatever. And so Candy really feels slighted by that. Like, you know, you show me your hand one time, should I give you a second time to show me your hand if it's right or if it's wrong? And so Candy's having some debatable issues about whether she really want to trust these ladies again, because they have done some things for her not to trust them. Like when she, you know, if they were starting out and they were young and it was kids, but you can understand why Tasha probably got ahead of herself. She was young, people in her ear, a boyfriend is her manager, that's not her husband. That probably got to her head that she really did just understand things, especially was back in the 90s. So she was acting like the diva, and Candy ain't feeling that. And Candy's like, you know, I'm the shit now. And so Tasha said, no, it wasn't like that. You know, Rocky was really supportive and all this other stuff, and he helped out. And so now we get back to, like, they got 11 days before the BET Awards, and just like, yo, it seems like Tasha is that type of person that she can get real grown. And plus, she probably felt like she's the leader of the group, and she said she's the voice of the group, and she's the oldest one in the group. So she probably felt like they were her minions or whatever. Like, you guys stay over here, I got my own room, I'm the queen bee of this group or whatever. So now the ladies get ready for the rehearsal. Tiny walks in, was like, ladies, we all gotta talk. We gotta sit down and talk. Like, if anybody got anything going on, we're not on the same page, you got any questions, something you ain't feeling right about something, speak now, forever hold your peace. And so Candy was like, oh, so I guess you're talking about what happened the other day when I left here and I wasn't feeling good. Yep, we're talking about that, Candy. We're talking about how you was crying all up in the parking lot and all this other stuff. And so, you know, Candy was like, yo, I don't really like the way that, you know, Everyone said that we're coming back. And, you know, Candy's just like, I don't like the way you guys put my name on a business without my permission. Everything's done behind my back. It's like, I'm not on the same page with you guys. You guys are talking. I'm not talking to you guys. And so Tasha was like, what are you talking about? You know, Tamika, she apologized to you and everything. You said if she apologized to you that we can work again and everything will be cool and we back. And so Tasha was like, so then why did you say that we coming back then if you feel this way? If you feel like we're not on the same page and you feel like you're jumping ahead of yourself and you feel like you want to, you know, slow it down or whatever, you know, because Candy's just saying like, I just wanted to see like how these first couple of performances go and how we get along and how everything goes. But she didn't relay that message to, you know, Tamika and Tasha. And so then Candy was like, well, I did tell Tiny, and but you didn't tell the rest of the group. So then Tasha was like, yo, it's like we told everybody that we're coming back. We said we was doing this thing. What about it's not just us in the room, it's our fans, it's so many other things that are involved. And it was like, yo, Candy, you should have just expressed yourself and said it. And Candy was like, well, I didn't really know. It's like it just happened overnight. You know, it's just like everything's happening overnight. Everything's happening so fast and I don't really know. And so you know, Tasha was like, how come you didn't talk to us? And you know, Candy was like, I don't talk to y'all. We haven't been talking, like we don't really talk or whatever. So how am I gonna talk to you guys? I've been talking to, you know, Tiny. And Tiny was like, yeah, I'm tired of being the messenger. You know what I'm saying? I'm tired of being the messenger. And so, you know, Tasha was like, you should have told us how you felt. You should have told us, you know what I mean? Because Tasha feels like you holding us back, you know what I mean? And Tasha was like, yo, you need to take accountability for yourself, because you said that we're back, we're doing this thing, and now all of a sudden you're not. And then Candy goes, no, you need to take accountability for yourself. And so then they go back and forth. And so then that's when Candy just laid out on the table. She was like, yo, don't tell me accountability. What about you? I mean, you set up our third album so you can get your solo deal. So like, that's shady. So Candy was just like, yo, for us to get our third album, you negotiated a deal for your single album to Tasha. And she was like, yo, and so you can get your solo deal. And she was like, you know, we were supposed to get $4 million for you know, our third album, and we all thought we was going to get so much money, but we didn't get so much money because you negotiated a deal for your third album single, for the single. So order for us to get our third album, then you said that you was the voice of the group, you didn't want to do any promotions and all this other stuff. And so, you know, Candy was just like, yo, you're mad shady because we thought we was going to get $4 million. And then you turn around, you negotiate a deal for your own solo album. And then, you know, you left us out in the cold. Like, you only thought about yourself. So, you know, Candy's just like, yo, so don't even come at me with no shady shit. Don't even come at me like I supposed to told you everything when you did us dirty. You did all of us dirty, including your sister. But she didn't say all that. I'm adding on to it. And so Tasha was like, no, I didn't. I didn't do that. I was going to get my solo deal because of me. I wasn't going to get my solo deal because of you. And she was like, my voice was going to get the solo deal. That's what got me the solo deal, is my voice. Yeah, right, Tasha. You negotiated that third album to get your solo deal, why they get less money. And then so, you know, and then that's when Tiny finally said something. And Tiny said, like, you know, Tiny finally said something. She was like, yo, she is telling the truth. That's the truth. Because Candy said, our lawyers told us that we're not going to get the $4 million because Tasha said that she's not going to be promoting the album and she's the voice of the group and she wants her solo order to get a third album. She wants her solo deal. And so then, you know, the record company didn't want to fuck with the record company, didn't want to mess with them, didn't want to be a part of them or whatever. So you think about it, like, they had two albums out. Them two albums were banging. So they should have got more money. Like, you know, they should have got some real money. And they didn't. And so that's when Tiny was like, yeah, that's what happened. We were supposed to get $4 million, but we didn't get $4 million. We ended up getting $800,000 because the lawyers and everybody said that you didn't want to do promotion for the album. You didn't want to do this. You didn't want to do that. And you was also threatening or acting like you was going to leave the group. So the record label thought that they wasn't going to get their money back. So they didn't want to give us the $4 million. So that's why we got $800,000 for our third album. They had two album's already out. Did they prove themselves? So their third album, they only got $800,000 to split four ways, then play management, then pay for all the services they had on tour, recording time, studio time, dressing, you know, makeup, hair, all that other stuff. So they probably walked away with probably nothing. So Candy stood up, and so then Tiny finally stood up and said that. And so that's when, you know, Candy was like, so Tamika, isn't that what happened? You don't remember? You gonna act like you don't remember? This didn't happen. Tamika was like, I don't want nothing to do with it. I don't want nothing. I don't know. I don't remember. And so Candy was like, that's what I'm talking about. Nobody speaks up. I'm the only one speaking up. And you go, Candy, because you're the businesswoman and you know your shit now. So you ain't taking it. And it's just that you just got to keep being strong and let them know that you're the alpha right now. But, you know, you guys can all work together. And I hope you guys all do work together. And, you know, continue to do tours and things like that. But that was mad shady. That was low down. Like, you know, hearing that would make me not even want to get back into the group or whatever. But Candy's doing it because, you know, it's good promotion. It's good for her. Something else, another business venture that she can do. Then on top of that, you know, and she got a show out of it, and then they're performing different places, they're selling out seats, so it's another venture deal for her. But she don't really have to do it, but the other girls need it. Not Tiny probably don't need it like that, but she wants it because she wants to, they want to see what they can do or whatever. So I was like, damn, Tasha, you shady. And then on top of that, you're not owning up to it. You're not admitting what you did. You're not admitting anything. So it also sounds like you have a flawed type of personality that you can't even, like, if you really want to amend things with Candy, you really want to make this group work, like, you'll just lay your cards out on the table because they already know. Just own up to it. You know what you do, you do. Up to it. So you know, Tamika was like, I don't want to get involved because last time I got involved, you know, the group broke up, and you know, I went around and I spread lies about Candy, talking about she broke up the group because she slept with Jermaine, she slept with his father, she slept with everybody in the business. And I only did that because, you know, Candy was going around telling people the group really broke up because of, you know, Tasha and her solo career, whatever, which was the truth. And so, you know, Tamika really don't want to face the facts, and she really doesn't want to throw her sister under the bus because that's her sister. But right is right and wrong is wrong, and if you really want this group to work, you all got to be honest and just admit what happened and heal them wounds so you can move forward. Because Candy's still hurt. She's still, because she thought you guys were her sisters. And we hear that Mama Joyce, you know, fed you guys, put clothes on you, she helped manage you and all this other stuff. And so now they can't perform or nothing because the band is gone. And so now, Tasha asked to talk to Candy or whatever after everything was over. And so Tasha and Candy, they start to talk, whatever. And so, you know, Tasha was like, so what's the problem? What did I do? How can I change this? How can we make this work? How can we get on the same page? And it's like, well, the first thing you can do, Tasha, is actually own up to what you did and tell the truth about how you behaved and just be honest with Candy, because she ain't gonna let it go. Because in order for her to move on, she needs to know that you understood how you hurt her, how you mistreated her, how you turned your back on her when you were supposed to be her big sister, when you said you was her big sister. So Candy was like, yo, I don't know how we're gonna be on the same page. Candy was like, we never been on the same page. We never seen eye to eye. I always thought that you never liked me or whatever. And I even told, you know, Tamika, I felt like your sister don't like me. And then that's when, you know, Tasha was like, I always liked you. I always had your back or whatever. Even when you and Tamika would get into it, she would always have your back. And then, you know, Candy was like, nah, nobody ever had my back. I felt alone. I felt bad in this group. It was like, it was y'all against me, and I never had a voice. When we was on tour, I used to call my mom and tell her how bad it was. But at one point in time, I had my brother, Patrick was there, and he helped the ladies. He helped them get along. He kept them close. And then, you know, Tamika was like, Patrick was a wonderful guy and I had a crush on him, and he was able to mellow us out and have us understand. And then, you know, Tasha also describes that, you know, when Tamika and Candy got into an argument, he was able to just smash it real quick and tell them, never ever fight with your sisters, never ever fight with your family. And that's that old school, you know, type of, you know, guy that actually loves you and teaching you women how to, how to act and be together, and also love you guys and not looking at you guys as cash cows, as the other people that came into your life and in a group and put things in your ears and stuff like that. So Candy brother, you know, he was like a mediator for the group. And once Candy lost her brother, because he died in that car accident in Mexico, and I'm so sorry for her loss. That shit is mad sad, you know. And watching this show brings me back to so many different memories of so many people that were here when Xscape was out in the 90s, that so many people that are not here anymore, how we used to dance to this song, how we used to sing this song, how when we go to school dances or go out, we'll play this song or ride around the car, listen to Xscape and things like that. We were young teenagers, and this show just brings back so many memories. Once I hear the songs, it takes me back to my childhood. And so, you know, Candy was like, once my brother was gone, I had nobody else. I was just by myself. And so Candy starts to cry. Tasha starts to cry, whatever. And I was like, how can we make this better? How can we get this right? And Candy was like, she was just telling it the truth. She was like, yo, I felt like I was always the odd man out, and now I feel like I'm still the odd man out, and it shouldn't be like that. And that's how I was in my last video. I was explaining how Candy feels, because you can see it in her face that she's still hurt, and she still feel like she's trapped as that child. She's still trapped in them emotions where she was calling her mom crying and shit like that. So they need some help. But I think if Tasha apologized and own up to what she did, I think they can move forward, because that's all Candy really wants, is for her to be honest why the group really broke up, what really happened between the group. That's what Candy really wants, you know, Tasha to explain. And so then we get to, you know, Tasha is just like, well, you know, we got to get this right. We got a performance. We got to sing. We got a rehearsal tomorrow. So they hug it out and then they leave. We get Tasha. She goes out to some nice restaurant with her husband. And basically he tells her that this is how Candy's feeling. Candy's feeling this way because you got a solo deal. The shit didn't work out for you. Now you want her back. And you know what I was hearing? And then her husband, Ricky, says, Rocky says, Tasha's husband, Rocky says that, you know, you went solo, but, you know, I got the, you know, Grammy. So that's what Rocky was saying. He was hearing that, oh, Tasha went solo, but she didn't get a Grammy, and Candy got a Grammy or whatever. And so, you know, Rocky's like, you got to look at it the way she's looking at it, that you coming begging for her back after she felt like you did her wrong. And then that's when Tasha was like, I didn't even get the deal. I didn't even get anything that was promised to me. Everything got messed up because Jermaine Dupri got fired or left Sony, and she never did her solo deal or anything like that. She got lost in the shuffle. That's why they should have stayed together. And that's probably why, like Candy said, if Patrick was still alive, her brother, that they probably would have lasted a lot longer than they did. And so it is what it is with that situation. And you know, everybody's coming to the rehearsals late. Everybody's just coming to the rehearsals late, and it's not cool at all. And then we get Candy. She's with, you know, she's with Todd or whatever. And Todd was like, Todd and Rocky are both being very supportive of the girls getting back together and working together. Todd knows his wife doesn't need the money or whatever, but he feels like it's probably something that a bucket list that she do want to complete and finish, is actually see, like, if they can actually do it again, if they can actually work together, if they can actually mend the relationship, if anything. I think Candy wants to see if she can make the relationship work, because they've been knowing each other since they was kids. They grew up together. They made money together. They made music together. They did a lot of wonderful things together, even though it went sour. So Todd is basically being supportive, and so is Rocky. And so then, you know, they get to rehearsals. The ladies are late or whatever. And so we get to, you know, Tamika, we meet her two daughters. Her husband's a security guard. So if he's a security guard, she really needs this paper. She really needs this group to work. So why ain't her ass there on time? Why isn't he making sure his wife is there at rehearsal on time if he's only a security guard? She got two daughters. They're very beautiful. One's getting married. Her name is Osha. And then the other one, I forgot the other girl's name. She writes music and everything. And we learned that when Tamika was in the group in 1993, she got pregnant. And, you know, the record label, they wanted her to have an abortion. She refused to. And they was going to kick her out the group. And so that's when, you know, Tasha said, if my sister got to leave, then I'm going to leave too. So Tamika was able to stay in the group because her sister had her back. So, anyways, it's just like crazy. They had a lot of shady shit going on. Jermaine just played these girls. And then these girls got big heads. People got into their mind. And they were young. And they didn't have that stableness of somebody that was real, that was around them. The one person they did passed away. Mama Joyce, she couldn't be around all the time. And so you have many shady people. I wonder if any negative sexual things happen to these ladies. Because you hear about what's going on now in the media with, you know, the industry of Hollywood and the music business and acting business. Like, hopefully nothing bad happened to them. So basically they're getting ready for the Essence Awards or whatever. Tiny meets up with her daughter, you know, Zynique, and basically she's performing at the BET Awards. She's going to be doing a show before the BET Awards, and Tiny's out there talking to her daughter. It's all good or whatever. And so now you got Candy. She's back at the studio, and she's waiting for the girls to show up. And, you know, she's waiting for them to show up, and they ain't trying to show up. They're late. She's sitting there waiting for hours. She wait for 2 to 3 hours. If they're really serious about the group, why are they not there on time or anything? And they have only so much amount of time left. So anyways, they finally show up. But, you know, Candy's on the phone talking to Todd. She was like, you know, I've been here like 2 hours, 3 hours waiting on them. And so Todd was like, yo, you got real businesses. Since you're out of town, you can't really make, you know, your business deals go down, and you're missing calls and shit like that. And then they start a business in your name and they can't even show up on time. He's just like, he feels like it's some gutter bucket shit. And so everybody shows up. They're all late. You know, Candy's pointing out that they are late. And then on top of that, you know, what's her name? Tiny brings up that they sold out in Detroit, and they got to get it together because people really want to see them, and they're selling tickets. And Candy said, I really feel good about that. People really want to see us. That means that, you know, we got to do it, because we can't go on the BET Award while it is live and then fall off stage or be terrible. People's going to be like, they ain't going to want their tickets. They ain't going to want to purchase their tickets or whatever. And so now they're getting, you know, they're practicing. Guess who walks through the door? None other than Mama Joy. She walks in, and she likes it. She likes them. But I also gotta mention, Tasha and Candy went to the studio. Tasha went to Candy's studio, and they worked well together. But Tasha is humbling herself because her husband is training her. Hey, listen, you better make it work with Candy. You gotta make her be on the same page. You gotta get on the same page. You gotta bust down that door, break that glass, and work with her, because this is your only hope right now. We ain't gonna get a second chance to do this, Tasha. So you gotta make it right, because you and her are the one that has the biggest problem, and you gotta let go of that control. That's what, you know, Rocky's saying. Come on, you gotta get back in the door. Get hot, man. So you can put some music on, then you can leave the group again. I wonder if Candy feels like they might leave her or whatever once they get hot or they get all this exposure again. You think Candy feels that way? So anyways, you know, Candy and Tasha also talks about, you know, Michael Jackson, that Michael Jackson seen them perform at the, I guess, the Essence Awards, one of these awards show, and they were singing Understanding, and Michael Jackson was waving his hands at them. And then Candy and Tasha talking about, you know, and look at us, we're back together now. So hopefully, you know, they can mend these wounds and they can work shit out, because it'll be nice to see these women that have children, that are married, that are somewhat successful. But Candy's really successful, and, you know, that raised their kids, that they can mend their wounds and get back together and do business and be strong and powerful. That'll be cool. So Mama Joyce is liking them or whatever, but she tells him, you guys need to stop worrying about dancing and just sing. Just be the singers. That's all you need to do is sing. That's all people want to see, if you can still sing. You guys ain't dancers. Let other people do that shit. Just sing. Anyways, peace. I'm out. One love. Thank you to all my peeps and my peoples. But Tasha's a trip, huh? Tasha's a trip. She needs to own up to it and be honest with it. Her and Candy could do a lot of things together. Peace, I'm out. And Candy also said, I'm not that same little scary girl I was before, that I didn't know the music business. I know the music business. I'm in the business. I am the business. I'm the boss. So you can't come in here and run this and run me over and tell me I got to listen to what you got to say, because I ain't a child no more. This is what I do. I done wrote Grammys, baby. I won a Grammy, baby. Peace, I'm out.